Welcome to Lecture 1.2, Introduction to Linear Programming Models in Quantitative Techniques for Decision Making, Mathematical Methods, or Operations Research. By the end of this discussion, you should be able to define linear programming, define the objective function, decision variables, and constraints of an LP model, create or formulate an LP model from a given LP problem. Let us talk about linear programming. Linear programming is a quantitative decision-making technique used to determine the best use of resources. Let's put an emphasis on this. It dates back to the 20th century when George Danzig invented LP derived from operational research which was developed in Great Britain for wartime operations, particularly the allocation of wartime equipment. Okay, take note that linear programming is one of the bases of decision making. Always remember, when making decisions, especially when it comes to business, we should have a basis or logical reason or anything that backs us up so that our decision will be correct. And linear programming is one of those quantitative techniques. Optimization is the process of finding the feasible and best solutions given the limited amount of resources that will either maximize profit or minimize costs. A linear programming or LP model is an algorithm set for a specific problem given its condition. The programming should not be confused, okay, with the computer programming, as the programming in the LP simply means formulating a course of action. Kasi baka mamaya, pag nakinig nyo lang linear programming, ang may isip nyo, gagamit ng codes or ng computer. But it's not. May mga computer applications tayo. However, yung pinaka-idea ng linear programming, it just simply means you're trying to do a program. You're trying to do a course of action. Yung sunod-sunod. So, in this case, we are trying to do a solution in which we are finding a solution to a given problem. Ano ba yung magiging steps natin to solve it? What will be our basis? Yan. These are the components of a linear programming model. So, we have three. The decision variables, objective functions, and constraints. So always remember these. Let us define them one by one. First, we have the decision variables. These are the ones that we seek to determine, and the quantities involved represented each by distinct symbols. Meaning to say, we are going to use distinct variables. Okay, distinct representations of each variable that are involved, of each variable that is involved. Decision variables. Objective function. It's a linear equation that involves the decision variables. It is either to be maximized or minimized. Constraints. These are the conditions that must be satisfied and the objective function is subject to. Okay, it is the conditions that must be satisfied. These are expressed as equality or inequality. So, we have reviewed inequality in the previous lecture. Like what I mentioned earlier, the objectives of linear programming are minimize cost and maximize profit. Let's have an example on the minimize cost or the min C. Take note that we can also write this one as lowercase min C, or in other textbook, it's min W. Okay, W is just a variable to represent cost. Okay, you will know later why we will use W. Okay, this is an example. An engineer wants to determine how many pieces of bolts and nuts and liters of paint he must buy to minimize the cost in building his home against the requirement of the National Building Code. Next, maximize profit or max P. Ito, pwede rin naka lowercase. Or in this case, kagaya nung sa W kanina, usually ang ginagamit ay capital Z. A jeweler wants to determine how many pieces of silver and gold she must sell to maximize her profit. Lagyan natin ng highlight yung mga words, no? Maximize her profit against the demand of her customers and the supply of raw materials. Now that we have already talked about the objectives and the decision variables, let's talk about the constraints. May dalawang klase ng constraint. First is the explicit constraint. These are the constraints that are explicitly stated in the problem. And the second one, implicit, these are the constraints that are implied. The non-negativity constraint. Since real-life LP problems will not involve negative values, for example, there is no negative 3 kilograms of salt, negative 5 inches long, or negative 19 units of cell phone. Diba? Wala tayong mga negative values in real life. Dapat mga positive lang. The non-negativity constraint, an implicit constraint, has to be observed and mandatorily written. Okay, we have this. Halimbawa, meron tayong decision variable na X and Y. Ito yung corresponding non-negativity constraint. X is greater than or less than 0 or Y is greater than or less than 0. Take note na pwedeng mag-0, yes, yung decision variables natin. Or kapag naman naka-X lang tayo, meron tayong subscripts X1 and X2. This is the general form of an LP model. First, you have the objective function. Okay, this is the objective function. As you can see, nandito sa unahan yung objective mo, maximize. And then the capital Z, that is the representation of the cost or the profit. In this case, this one represents the profit. Okay, this one is equal to C1X1 plus C2X2 plus until CNXN. Take note that X1, X2, until X sub N are the decision variables. Subject to, okay, this one means subject to. Subject to the following constraints, you have A1, X1 plus A2, X2 until A sub N, X sub N is greater than or equal to A, okay, until these, okay? And then this one is the non-negativity constraint. So always remember that you are required to write this. Otherwise, the LP model will be incorrect. If you do not write this, your LP model will not be restricted to positive values only. Meaning to say, you will consider negative values, which is incorrect. Alright, take note that the left-hand side of the constraint are linear. When you say linear, you have a variable here in degree 1. Before we formulate the linear programming model, let's talk about the properties. First, proportionality. Since LP models are linear, any increase or decrease in the value of a decision variable will result to a corresponding proportional increase or decrease to the objective function and the constraints. Before, halimbawa, meron tayong maximize P equals 3X plus 2Y. Suppose that our solution is X is equal to 3 and Y is equal to 2. So, the profit will be, pag sinabsitute natin, 13. However, kapag in-increase natin yung X natin from 3 to 10, magkakaroon din tayo ng increase sa ating profit. So as you can see, it is proportional. So if we increase, the profit will also increase. If we decrease, it will decrease. Second, additivity. The total contribution of all the decision variables is the direct sum, okay, of the individual contributions of each, and that the variables are independent of one another. For example, the total profit of a jeweler comes from the sum of his profit from gold and from silver jewelries. Next, we have the divisibility. The decision variables can take on any real numerical values within a specific... Next, we have divisibility. The decision variables can take on any real numerical values within a specified range, meaning it can assume fractions, numbers with decimals, or even zero. The variables in an LP model is continuous, not discrete. Okay, in any case na halimbawa nagkaroon ng decimal number yung sagot natin, pero dapat discrete yung problem, ina-apply natin doon yung pwede tayo mag-round off and pwede rin tayo mag-sensitivity analysis. We'll discuss that later. Okay, magbigay tayo ng halimbawa ng continuous at saka ng discrete. Okay, continuous data, temperature, height, money. Okay, take note that money is a continuous data kasi may decimal yan. For the discrete, halimbawa we have number of pieces of gold jewelries. Number of number of bottles to be manufactured. Okay? So as you can see, these are discrete because hindi pwede magkakaroon ng decimal yan. Those are whole numbers, natural numbers. Now, let's talk about how to formulate an LP model. First, determine the decision variable. So that is the one of the most important. That is the pivotal step. Second, formulate the objective function. Determine whether you're going to minimize or maximize it. Third, look for the constraints, both explicit and implicit, and transform them into equality or inequality. All of these tell you to read the problem carefully. Okay? Important tip, always be consistent in the unit of measure used. The decision variables are homogeneous. Let us now formulate the LP model of the following problem. David Electronics Incorporated produces two kinds of calculator, scientific and graphing calculators. Long-term projections indicate an expected demand of at least 200 scientific and 160 graphing calculators each day. Because of limitation in production capacity, no more than 400 scientific and 340 graphing calculators can be made daily. To satisfy shipping contract and condition, a total of at least 400 calculators must be shipped daily. If each scientific calculator gives 1,200 and each graphing calculator gives 2,500 pesos profit, how many units of each type should be made daily to maximize the profit? As you can see, it's really overwhelming because that's a lot of words, okay? Now, ano yung magiging technique natin para malaman natin kung ano yung decision variables? Take a look at the final question. How many units of each type should be made daily to maximize the profit? Diyan manggagaling yung ating decision variable. Let me write it. Let X be we have x is equal to the number of units of scientific calculator to be produced. And then, similarly, y. Pwede kang mag x1 or x2 dito. Okay, we have x and y. For x, we have number of units of scientific calculators, and for y, number of units of graphing calculators. Take note that the decision variables must be stated like this. You must be specific. Pag halimbawa, sinabi mo dito, let x be the number of units of scientific calculators, ganyan lang, this is wrong. So you should be stating the complete thought. Yung x sa y natin, itong number of units na to, hindi pa yan napoproduce. So we are trying to do a decision basis. So that's why we have to be produced here. So it must be included. Okay, now that we already have our decision variables, let us create the objective function. Okay, how will we create the objective function? Nandito din yan sa pinakahuling question. Okay, we have, ilan daw yung, we are trying to maximize the profit. So in this case, we have max C. Pwede rin kayong gumamit ng max P. Okay, but in this case, I'm using the general variable that is being used in linear programming, the capital Z. Okay, max Z is equal to, we have, of course, ang profit, x plus y yan. Okay. Wherein x is the number of units and y is the number of units of scientific and graphing, respectively. Ngayon, ano yung magiging coefficients ng x and y? Tignan natin yung problem. Ito, in particular, this line. If each scientific calculator gives this profit, ayan. Ayan, naka-turquoise. Okay, we have, ang scientific, 1,200. And then the graphing, 2,500. Alright, this is our objective function. Okay, for starter, sige, lagyan natin ng label. So, ito yung ating decision variables. After writing the objective function, below it, you should write subject to the following constraints. So, ano yung mga constraints natin? Okay, let's put a highlight on the possible constraints. Long-term projections indicate an expected demand of at least, ayan. So, meron tayong demand constraint. Sige, how will we write this? So, may demand ng at least 200 scientific and 160 calculators each day. Okay, for the demand ng scientific, magkahiwalay yan. Hindi natin yan pag-aa din. So, we have x is greater than or equal to 200. Take note na naka-at least tayo. So, that is this one. Ang minimum na demand ay 200. So, that is the first, this is the first constraint. And then next, we have 160 graphing calculators naman. So, that will be y is greater than or equal to 160. So, ito yung demand constraint. Next, because of limitation in production capacity, no more than scientific and 340 graphing calculators can be made daily. Panibagong constraint na naman yon. So, it's one of the conditions that must be satisfied. So, let's put a highlight. Ayan, limitation. Ayan, no more than. Ayan. Dito na lang natin lagay. Ganun ulit. So, we have x less than or equal to 400. And then y less than or equal to 340. So, ito yung ano natin, production, supply, constraint. Next, to satisfy, I'm not going to highlight this anymore. To satisfy shipping contract and condition, a total of at least 400 calculators must be shipped daily. Okay, how will we write that in the inequality form or equality? X plus Y. X plus Y at least, so greater than or equal to 400. So ito yung shipping contract. Ayan. Tapos na. So, these are the constraints that are explicitly stated here. So, ito yung mga i-consider natin in finding the number of units na dapat ma-produce. And then, last but not the least, never ever forget. X is greater than or equal to 0 and Y is greater than or equal to 0. So, this is the non-negativity constraint. Pag hindi mo nilagay itong non-negativity constraint, it will be considered wrong. Second example, Donet intends to invest a total of 100,000 in either his life insurance or a bank account or both. His life insurance pays 10% per year and the bank pays 8%. Donet thinks life insurance is riskier, so he intends to put at most 40,000 into the bank and at least 30,000 into the life insurance. How much must he allot to each investment to maximize his returns? Okay, let's highlight the last sentence, which is the question. Okay. From the previous example, you already have a hint how to create the decision variable. Let X be the amount to be invested. Okay, ano ba? Life insurance. Dalawa yung kanyang pagpipilian. Life insurance sa bank account. So, X amount to be invested in bank account. Life insurance muna. And then Y, let me just copy this. Okay, for Y, we have, alright, for Y, we have bank account. Okay, these are our decision variables. Next, let us create the objective function. Take note that here we have maximize. So, our objective function will be max Z. And then, it will be consisted of X plus Y again. Now, ano yung ilalagay natin sa coefficient nila? Take note that we are talking about the returns when you invest something, okay? Kapag nag-i-invest tayo, may interest na pumapasok. Now, asan yun dito sa problem? So, it says here, his life insurance pays 10% per year and the bank pays 8%. Okay, meaning to say, whichever, kung magkano man yung ininvest niya doon sa dalawa, i-multiply natin sa 10% pati 8% pareho para makuha natin kung magkano yung makukuha niya. So, it means that the coefficient of x and y in this problem will be, for x, we have 0.10 or 0.1. So, that is 10%, and then the other one, 0.08. This one is our objective function. Subject to the following constraint. Okay, the first sentence, Donet intends to invest a total of 100,000. Okay, it means that x plus y. Okay, is equal to 100,000. Take note na ito, naka-equal sign tayo because it says here that total of 100,000 yung gusto niyang i-invest. So, it's not at least, it's not at most, at least, as in total yung sinabi. In this problem, take note that ang sinabi, he intends to invest a total of 100,000. Meaning to say, he is not going to invest at least or at most, at least, fix talaga na 100,000 yung kanyang i-invest. So, it should be an equal sign. Donet thinks life insurance is riskier, so he intends to put at most 40,000 into the bank. Sige, highlight natin. Okay, into the bank. Tapos, yung isa, okay. For the turquoise, at most 40,000 into the bank. Yung bank natin Y, no? So we have Y is less than or equal to 40,000. And then for the life insurance X, we have X is greater than or equal to 30,000. So, these are our explicit constraints. Okay, yan na yon. Kailangan ma-maximize yung profit natin subject to the following. First constraint, kailangan yung sum ng X at saka Y, 100,000. Second constraint, the X should be greater than or equal to 30,000. And the third constraint, Y should be less than or equal to 40,000. We should satisfy these all. Okay, and last but not the least, we have the non-negativity constraint. X, Y is greater than or equal to 0. You are highly encouraged to answer the following exercise for you to practice. Take note that we are going to solve these problems in Lecture 2.